Namaste to everyone. This is Professor Venkataramu B.R., Assistant Professor of English, Department of Collegiate and Technical Education, Government of Karnataka. I am working at Government First Grade College, Gudibande. So, welcome you all to this Digital Learning Management System Initiative of Government of Karnataka. Well, this is an English class for the students of BCom 4th semester of Bangalore North University and also Bangalore University. We are learning a lesson titled Presentation Skills. Well, this is the lesson that we have started in the session number 39, where I have given introduction to the concept like presentation skills. Now let's come to the detailed study of the lesson. In this session, the contents include structure of presentation slides and also tips for effective presentation, and then we have some examples. Watch the video till the end so you will not miss any point. It will be most useful for your examination, also for your future growth. Well, let's come to the point now. The first and foremost thing is that how to structure presentation slides. Well, presentation slide structuring involves a lot of points. Let me give you the first and foremost thing is that we need to have the introduction slide. Well, what does introduction slide consists of? Keep in mind that we are preparing introduction slide means there should be title of presentation, date, and also presenter's name. These are the important things that we need to have the first and foremost slide that we prepare. Come to the next thing, outline slide. This outline slide consists of 5 points. Let me remind the first and foremost thing you should keep in mind while preparing this outline slide. You need to have the main points of what you will talk about. The second important point in the outline slide is that you have to follow the structure you have laid out. The third point is that start broad, finish specific. The fourth one is decide what needs to go into each slide. The fifth one is simplicity. Well, with this, let's move on to the third important slide that's called content slide. What is there in the content slide? In the content slide, you should keep in mind that you have to cover detailed information based on your outline. The second thing is that as many slides as you need, you can prepare. Remember, PowerPoint is more visual than verbal. A picture is worth 1,000 words. Use pictures wherever necessary. Now let's come to the final slide. How final slide should be structured? The audience will take away the last thing you say. So make the last slide highly meaningful. Provide contact information for follow-up. Pose a question for discussion. Finish with a joke or light-hearted conclusion. The third important fact is that place the blank slide at the end. This provides a non-distracting placeholder for discussion. Also, it prevents clicking through back to the beginning. Well, now let's come to the text of the presentation. The first thing you have to keep in mind while preparing the text for the PowerPoint presentation. Highlight your presentation. Don't create a substitute for it. Bullet points are required, not complete sentences in the PowerPoint presentation. Each slide may have 4 to 6 points. It won't be fair if you use more than that in a PowerPoint presentation. No large blocks of text. The audience stops listening and reads them. So don't put so much of stuff in the each slide of the PowerPoint presentation. You please consider showing 1 point at a time using animation. It helps the audience focus on what you are seeing. Now let's come to the images. The images are used widely in the PowerPoint presentation. But what kind of image should be used? Please avoid a clip art because everyone has seen it before and it lacks emphasis too. Images should be good, not pixelated, out of focus. It's maybe too dark. Please avoid such kind of images. Images have to be used after cropping them properly because it is going to distract our ideas if it's not properly cropped. Now let's move on to the use of graphs and diagrams in the PowerPoint presentation. The first and foremost thing that you have to keep in mind, while using the graphs and diagrams is that make the graphs or diagrams as simple as possible. You have to prepare the graphs and diagrams such that they can be grasped in just a few moments. Now let's come to the designs. Your PowerPoint presentation is attractive when there is a proper design. So, use a consistent background and layout for all the slides. Friends, second important thing with respect to design is that the template sets the tone for your presentation. Third point is that choose it carefully. When you set a design, properly choose it and be careful when choosing the proper design for it. Avoid bright background or cluttered layouts so that it will distract the audience. Now let's come to the fonts. Maybe fonts or maybe letter designs are very essential that really attracts the audience. Choose two types at most. Nothing cursive or ornamental, because cursive fonts may not be so easy to read. It will not capture the audience attention most of the time. Or even ornamental fonts may not be helpful to attract the audience's eyes. It is better to use sans serif fonts or Calibri or Times New Roman. Some of the most commonly used fonts people use it. And for the sake of legibility, you have to decide yourself which is the best font you can choose for your presentation. Well, the size of the fonts is also important. There should be a minimum of 18 points. Maybe from beginning from 18 to 20, 24 font size is used. And it should not be too big. That will also distract the audience also. The fourth important point you should keep in mind with respect to the fonts is that the main points, titles, should be bigger than the subpoints or content points. Likewise, fonts can be of two sizes. One is used bigger font, which is for main points or titles. Whereas subpoints, they require, or content points, they require smaller than the title fonts. That should keep in mind while preparing the PowerPoint presentation with respect to the fonts. Now let's come to the color of the PowerPoint presentation slides. The color is very much attractive because the color is the one that is going to speak a lot of things. It should be legible, it should be readable, it should be attractive, it should be beautiful. So with this background, you have to decide what color is required. I am sure the first point you should know, high contrast, dark and light, or maybe light on the dark. Likewise, you can think about the color of the slide. Use color with care to emphasize your talk, and also avoid extremely bright colors, hot pink colors, or neon orange, acid green colors, so that will not actually impress the audience. Do not combine red green, yellow, purple, or blue, orange, so that will not give good result in the slide. Now let's come to the animation. Animation is really the life that we are giving to presentation. Your ideas can survive with the PowerPoint animations. Use sparingly and be consistent while using animation. Avoid distracting or annoying sound effects. Next thing, important thing is that checking your work carefully. Maybe you have to take care about your spellings. So, hence, check the spellings and grammatical errors as many times as possible. So that your presentation should be free from grammatical and spelling errors. Check for logic and the flow of information. Sometimes the slides may be interchanged. Please check it yourself. Is it the logical flow maintained or not? And the information or the thought that you are going to continue is proper in way or not. Test your presentation in the room before your talk, because you may need to adjust the colors, templates, font size for the room, equipment, etc. Be prepared to give a talk without a PowerPoint show also, because some technical glitches do happen in the presentation. Well, now let's come to the tips for PowerPoint presentation. For an effective PowerPoint presentation, you need to follow these tips. The first and foremost thing is that you must be relaxed. Second point is that you have prepared and practiced, so your presentation will succeed and be enjoyable. And be smiling. The fourth point is that please keep in mind that the audience is on your side. The fifth point is that modulation of voice, body language and posture is very, very important. That body language plays important role. So while presentation, please see that these body language things are also maintained. The sixth one is that use a solid, well-rehearsed opening. Make an immediate and friendly impact. The seventh one is that the introduction should convey the topic and objectives of your presentation. The eighth one is that use confined body language. Control, be firm, speak your audience's language, accentuate the positive, be positive and upbeat. The ninth point is that pause when you need to. Don't apologize for it. Pausing is perfectly okay. The tenth point is that use audience's participation wherever possible. Be clear, calm, and conclude confidently. The 11th point is that in the end, allow the audience to ask questions and end positively. Thank the audience. Now friends, let's move on to the example that I can give you for PowerPoint presentation. One example I can give you from the textbook itself. This is an example on waste management at home. In the textbook, it's given slide 1. Welcome to the PowerPoint presentation on waste management at home by Professor Veda Vyasa. The second slide reads as, what is waste? What is waste management? How should waste be managed? Why waste management? Waste management concept. Now let's come to the third slide. In the third slide, it is written that waste is any material that is not needed by the owner, producer, or the processor. The fourth slide reads as, waste management refers to the correct collection and disposal of wastes. The fifth slide reads as, waste generated at home can be segregated into point number 1, wet waste, point number 2, dry waste, point number 3, e-waste. Slide number 6. In the slide number 6, we have main heading wet waste. Under this, we have the content, vegetable and fruit peels, eggshells, leftover food, paper napkins, tissue papers, etc. Let's come to the 7th slide. In the 7th slide, there is heading or title. It is written as dry wastes. The content is written as polythene bags, plastic cutlery, cups, plates, cosmetic products, aluminium foil, used soap, shampoo bottles, terra packs, toys, etc. Come to the 8th slide. In the 8th slide, the title is given as e-waste and the content is written as discarded electronic devices like computers, CDs, TV, music system, battery cells, cassettes, etc. Now come to the slide number 9. The title given is segregate waste and collect in separate bins. Here, 3 bins have been given, images of 3 bins. The first bin is titled as dry waste. Second bin is titled as wet waste. Third bin is titled as e-waste. And that's all about the PowerPoint presentation. For more details, please do refer the sources reference I have given here. Friends, I'm sure you have enjoyed this video lesson. If you like this, please give a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed to this channel, please do subscribe and press the bell button for notifications. Thank you for watching till the end. And please do wait for another video wherein I'm going to upload in the session number 41, where you will find the revision and also a small test, so that you could evaluate yourself. Thank you very much.